In this video, we will talk about parity in quantum mechanics, and in particular, how does the position operator change under a parity transformation? In general, a parity transformation means that you change the sign of every coordinate. So the position vector r would change to minus r. This is an example of a discrete transformation. A discrete transformation is something you can either do or don't do. You cannot apply a parity transformation just a little bit. The opposite of a discrete transformation is a continuous transformation. One example could be a rotation. With a rotation, you can do infinitesimally small steps until you reach the final rotation. This is not possible for a discrete transformation, like the parity transformation. Before we start, it's always important to decide whether we consider active or passive transformations. An active transformation changes the wave function itself. A passive transformation only changes the coordinate system, while the wave function remains the same. In this video, we will consider active transformations. Let us now talk about the properties of the parity operator pi. This operator can act on a wave function psi and give us psi prime. Our first requirement is that pi is a unitary operator such that it preserves the norm of a state. Next, if we let pi act twice on the same wave function, we should get the original wave function back, maybe including an overall phase factor. But since such an overall phase cannot be observed, we can just absorb it into the parity operator such that applying pi twice is the same as the identity operator. This means that pi is the same as its inverse, and the inverse is the same as the Hermitian conjugate. So in conclusion, this makes pi not only unitary, but also Hermitian. Now, how does pi act on the position operator? In the beginning of this video, we mentioned that, generally speaking, a parity transformation changes r to minus r. In order to formulate this in the language of quantum mechanics, we want that the expectation value of r using parity transformed wave functions is equal to the negative expectation value of r using the original wave functions. Since psi prime is equal to pi psi, we can write this equation like this, which must be true for any wave function psi. So the important thing is that this operator equation, pi dagger r pi is equal to minus r, is true. By using the fact that pi is both unitary and Hermitian, we can also write this using the anti-commutator of r with pi being equal to zero. But that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.